Shepherd of our soul, Shepherd of our soul,
Savior of our soul, Lover of our soul.
We are on the Lord's side. We
is according to us, the sweet lady, and the sweet lady to continue with the message you have given me. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. The Bible told us in the book of Peter, chapter number 3, verse 10 to 13. For he that will love life and see good days, let him refrain. Let him refrain his tongue from evil. Praise Mother Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I see that they speak no guile. Verse 11. Let him eschew evil. Let him eschew evil. And do good. Let him seek peace and ensure it. Let him seek peace and ensure it. 12. For the eyes of the Lord are over the righteous. This is where I'm going to. For the eyes of the Lord are over the righteous, and ears are open unto their prayers. But the face of the Lord, the eyes are facing. For the face of the Lord is from me. The face of the Lord is against them that doeth evil, irrespective of if you are born again, whoever you are. Once you do evil, the face of the Lord is against you. I'm going somewhere. Verse 13. And who is he that will harm you? Who is he that will kill you? Who is he that will destroy you? If, conditional statement, if you be followers of that which is good. The topic for this hour is keep iniquity far from your head of protection. Keep iniquity far. Keep iniquity away from your hedge of protection. Then I begin to ask myself this question since 2 days ago. It means I have to protect my hedge of protection for me to be protected. I have to protect my hedge of protection for my hedge of protection to be able to protect it. It is a giving and taking. It is bad, sir. If I don't protect my hedge of protection, it will be broken and I will be dead. It's when I'm able to secure my hedge of protection that my hedge of protection will be able to secure me. If somebody's with me, I want to wave your hand. Are you getting me now? Very Master Jesus. So the message the Lord is giving me and you this morning is this: we must protect our hedge of protection. We must secure our hedge of protection. How do we do this? We don't need to use God to secure our hedge of protection. All we need to do is to keep sin and iniquity far from ourselves. Then our security will be secured. The Bible told us in Job chapter 1, 9 to 10. After God had boasted to the devil, in verse 9, he said to the Lord God Almighty, then Satan answered, "Has no doubt," said, "has no doubt made an edge about him? Are you not the one protecting him? And about his house, and about all that he had on every side, that thou hast blessed the work of his hand, and his substance is increased in the land." But now, was Job the only one all over the earth that God had put an edge around him? Was Job the only person in that country that God had to bless him this way? That God had to fence around Job? Now, let's see what the Bible says in that same Job verse 1. Job chapter 1 verse 1. There was a man in the land of Luz, whose name was Job. And that man was what? Perfect. You cannot see what made God to do what he did. You cannot see what attracted God in him to do those things that Satan was naming before God. The Bible said this man was perfect and upright. The man was perfect and upright, and one that feared God. It means, even before all those blessings, it was the fear of God that attracted the edge of God around Job. It was uprightness that made God to bring all the affliction in heaven to guide Job around. It was his perfection that drew the perfect God to bring the perfect edge of protection around Job. And a man that eschewed evil, that run apart from evil, a man that you will see everything about him is genuinity. Everything about him, when he just tell you, "This is black, it is black." When Job tell you, "I am going to do this," that is exactly what he will do. He was never a man of hacky packy, an acting and betty man. So, because of his uprightness, because of the fear of God, God now made Job to be a terror before the devil. It means, before Satan can say all that he has said, it means he has been trying to penetrate. Devil on his own have tried everything to bring down Job. But because of the perfect edge around Job, he couldn't enter. He could not penetrate him. Now, the Bible told us, the book of Proverbs chapter 16 verse 7. If a man's ways pleases God, according to my brother, the word of God has no ambiguity. If a man's way pleases God, the Lord will bring bring our nation from heaven to surround him and paraphrase him. That God will make evil his enemy to be at peace with him. Is that not what the Bible says? Then, how can a master please God now in iniquity? How can a master please God now in sin? How can a man wait? How will you expect God not to make your enemy to be your friend when you yourself you are his enemy? How do you want God now to deploy his holy angels from heaven to come and guide you in your iniquity? How do I expect God now? If I am a man sleeping with other people's wife, a man that his tongue is so dirty, a man that will tell you this is black, and before I come to his wife, how do I expect our Lord to send his holy angels to come and guide me? It is not possible. That is why he's telling us this morning, if in this wicked world we want to be protected, if in this wicked world we want to be at peace as our brother preached in the morning, the peace of the Lord does not just come that way. God does not give you peace when you yourself you are giving headache. It's not possible. God will only give you peace when you yourself is a man of peace. When yourself is a man that runs from evil. So, for we to have the edge of God around us, say we must keep iniquity far from us. For we to call on God and to answer us and the place angel to be on God, we must first of all do the right thing. What is that right thing? We must eschew evil. We must fear God. We must be perfect. We must love God in the order of John. We read today in that John chapter 10, there was a place that said the scripture can never be broken. Did you know him today? The scripture cannot be broken. The Lord will never guide you and I in our iniquity. Then my eyes does not behold sin. How can we be sinning and we are asking God to come and protect us against the other demons that are also sinning? The wish that will come and destroy you is also sinning. You are sinning, you are sinning. Who God will not protect now? I'm rebelling. That one that I'm saying God come and protect me against is also rebelling. Who, how do you want God to come and protect me now? Our God is not a biased God. Our God is a God of justice. He fight a justifiable fight. He fight a clean battle. A stainless battle. A battle that when he fight it, say yes. I know my son was innocent. That's why I came down to fight. I want us to know this today. The same God created every one of us on earth. He owns everything. He owns all the witches and wizards, all the demons. Everything was created by him. It's only anyone that singles out of the rest will protect. What makes you different from demons is to take yourself out of sin. What makes you different from those which are wizards? Have you not heard the Bible say the sin of rebellion is as a sin of witchcraft? The sin of disobedience is the way God sees an armed robber, the same way he sees you and I that are living in hatred. He cannot protect you against an robber when you yourself you are a murderer, murdering people's life, the murdering people's character, like a gateful. Your own mandatory is even worse. And you are saying, God, come and protect me. Say, no. You have to first of all protect your edge of protection before your edge of protection can protect you. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. The Bible told us in Psalm chapter 34, verse 7, the angel of the Lord encampeth round about they that do iniquity. Is that what the Bible says there? Is that what the Bible says?
No.
The angel of the Lord encampeth round about they that fornicate. Those that do iniquity. Is that what the Bible says? No. The angels of the Lord. Psalm 34. Yes. Praise Mother Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The angels of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear him and deliver them. Is that not what the Bible says?
Yes.
Your edge of protection is your fear of God. My edge of protection is my righteousness. What we attract God to come and protect me is by doing His will. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You don't need to pray much. Your righteousness will attract the angels of God to protect you. The holiness will attract the holy angels to come out fight your battle for you. The angels of the Lord encamp round about the righteous and deliver them. Job chapter 4 verse 7. Submit yourself therefore to God. Resist the devil. The first thing is submission. And that your submission will not be the one to resist the devil for you. Submit yourself to God. Thou shalt not fornicate. I submit, I will not fornicate again. I will not steal again. I will not lie again. I will not disobey God again. As you do this, the edge of protection around you will get stronger and stronger and stronger. Praise Master Jesus. The power of the darkness will be running from us. Darkness will run away. When we run into light, what is light? Light is righteousness and holiness. All we need to do is to run into light. And Satan cannot come into light. How can we run into light? By embracing holiness and righteousness. Protect your edge of protection. Protect your edge of protection. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The Bible tells us in Proverbs chapter 11, verse 6, the righteousness of the upright shall deliver them. These are able to get that. The righteousness of the righteous, of the upright, will deliver him or her. The scripture cannot be broken. It is my righteousness, my holiness that will fight for me in the days of trouble. The righteousness of the righteous of the upright shall deliver them, but the transgressors shall be taken in their own naughtiness. It is simple. Why the Lord is telling me this? In case I am opening my mouth wide, overcome my fight and battle in iniquity, he will not come. Oh God, come and defend me when you are fighting somebody. So what he says, if you must pray and you are asking people to fight for you, first of all, that person you are fighting in your mind, forgive him. Forgive her, then I will come. I will also forgive you and fight for you.
Oh Lord, my God, say after me, my Father, my Maker, and you that is in
in iniquity you sin Satan, my father, my maker. I say, who is this one? Who is that way? Because of you, I will land stone upon all of them now. You must not say, my father, my maker, in iniquity. Instead of us to be saying, Father, have mercy upon us, I say, my father, my maker, come and fight my battle. He will not fight such. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. Ecclesiastes chapter 10. Ecclesiastes chapter 10, verse 8. He that digeth a pit shall fall into it. It is simple. And whoso breaketh an egg. Edge, serpent will bite you. I'm telling you this, the serpents are always revolving around your edge of protection. You can't do anything about it. Every child of God have an edge of protection. And every day, just as the children of Israel learn about the war of Jericho, 7 days after, Satan and his demons are learning about you. They are moving about you every day, looking for where the edge of protection will be broken and enter and destroy you. And at that time, you are digging a pit for somebody else. I mean, for somebody else, you are actually inviting Satan as agent to yourself. He that digged a pit, he that planned evil, shall fall into that evil, irrespective of being an apostle. God is not a biased God. God is not a man, okay, and because you give me 500 euros, and let me. No, you can't bribe him. Your 40 jets in his presence will not move it. The Bible says the day a righteous man fall into a sin and forget every of your righteousness. He that diggeth a pit shall fall in therein. Whoever that broke the edge, if Job has broken his edge, I tell you, Job will go down. Respect of what you have done before. So, the message for me this morning are you that let us protect our edge of protection. Our edge of protection needs protection. Sister, are you hearing me? Our edge of protection needs our protection too to protect us. Our edge of protection needs our protection to protect us. If you break it, you will be broken. If I break my edge of protection, I myself will be broken. Now, we are in the presence of God. We have come to seek His face. Is our edge of protection broken? And we say, Father, show us your face. He will not show us His face. Have we destroyed the trust He has for us? He trusted that my soul can never do this. I trust this my son. Even though the wife is not there, he can never do so sort of thing. And after I have done it, God forbid, I'll see come and say, Holy Ghost, fire. Am I not inviting strange fire upon myself? Yes. I must protect the image of God for God to protect me. Say, Father, give me grace to protect your image. God is looking for somebody who is protecting glory. God is looking for children, as Job did, who will protect his glorious image. And in that, he will also protect us. I love the message our brother put this morning. We need peace. The prince of peace cannot dwell in iniquity. The prince of peace is holy. The Bible Into the camp, all Israel shouted, they shouted. And when the Philistines heard the noise of the shout, they said, "What meaneth the noise of this great shout in the camp of the Hebrews?" And they understood that the ark of the Lord, empty ark, was come into the camp. And the Philistines were afraid, for they said, "God is come into the camp," and God was not there. And they said, "Woe unto us, for there have not seen such a thing before. Woe unto us, it who shall deliver us out of the hands of this mighty God." They knew that God is mighty. They knew that the edge of protection of the Lord of Israel is mighty. Then yet, these are the gods that smote the Egyptian with all the plagues in the wilderness. Go read that now. See the God inside. Then be strong and quit yourself like men, only Philistines. All ye Philistines, that ye be not servant unto the Hebrews, as they have been to you. Quit yourself like men and fight. And the Philistines fought, and they destroyed Israel with their empty ark of covenant. That is the God's plan. If you ever get it, it will tell your enemy your roots how to destroy you. We must protect our edge of protection. I don't know who is among us here. You are shouting, "Father, come and fight for me." Maybe God say, "Now the next shout I will hear from you, I will tell your enemy how empty you are until you repent of that sin." Praise Master Jesus. It is written, the Bible says, for God to come and fight for us, after your obedience is fulfilled, then the Lord God Almighty will avenge for you. Praise Master Jesus. Do you need you want God to fight for you? Fight for him first of all in righteousness and holiness. Praise Master Jesus. John chapter 9, verse 31. Now we know that God heareth not sinners. Now we know that God heareth not sinners. But if any man be a worshipper of God and doeth his will, he heareth. Sister, brother, are we praying in iniquity? It's better we stop praying for a while. Hallelujah. Are we calling on God on this mountain? He's saying, let us stop for a while and think about our relationship with him. The prayer that God hears most is the prayer of mercy. Let us protect our edge of protection. Proverbs 26, verse 27. Whoso digger the pit that falls therein, and he that rolls a stone, it will return upon him. Being a Christian, being a bishop, be whatever you call yourself, if you dig a pit against anybody, the Lord God will say, "I will roll it, I will make you to fall into it." And if you roll a stone against somebody, be an apostle to roll this. So therefore, we must know the kind of God we are. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The Lord help us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I say, God will help us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Isaiah chapter 10, verse 9. Isaiah chapter 1 from verse 15. And when you spread forth your hands, I will hide my eyes from you. Why? Because of sin. Oh my God, my Father, I am not hearing you, my daughter. If I am even your daughter. Hey, when you make many prayers, mountain of solution and redemption, hear this. When we make many prayers in iniquity, tomorrow now is our dry fast in our prayer. If we come tomorrow in iniquity, from 6 a.m. to 12 midnight in iniquity, he will not hear us. I will not hear. Your hands are full of blood. Everything comes to God as blood, as blood, as blood. Your hands are filled with blood. You see, wash you, make you clean, put away the evil of your doings from before my eyes. Cease to do evil. Cease to do evil. 17. Learn to do well. Seek judgment. Release the oppressed. Judge the fatherless. Plead for the widow. 18. Come now and let us reason together. Mountain of solution and redemption. Invitation again. Let us come to God now. Go on your knees now if you care and begin to reason with him now. There is an invitation now. There is an invitation now. Sister Maria, go to God now on your knees and begin to reason your sin with him. Brother Ferdinand, begin to reason your life with Jesus Christ now. Whoever that cares to listen to me, come now and let us reason together. Say the Lord of hosts, though our sin be as scarlet, he said, he will wash them, they shall be as white as snow. Though the sin be as scarlet, it doesn't matter how we come here. But he said, my children, come and reason with me. I want to purge you. They shall be white as wool. Verse 19. If you be willing and obedient, will your knees be bended now? If you be willing to tell God that you are a sinner, that you have lied, that you have fornicated, my heart is filled with hatred. I am a professor in marriage keeping. Father, have mercy upon me. Say, you shall be forgiven and eat the good of the land. The Lord will bring an edge of protection around you. But if you refuse to confess this hour, if you refuse to tell him who you are this hour, and you rebel against him, you live here, you came as a sinner. You shall be devoured. The Lord will give sword to your enemy. The Lord will empower that witch. We empower that household wickedness, that household demon to destroy you. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken it. What do we do now? Let us be with God. The Father, have mercy. Father, forgive us our sin. I am a man with undone lips, a man of lips. My heart is dirty. I easily get provoked. I easily keep malice in my profession. Father, have mercy. Gossip, jealousy is my second name. Father, have mercy upon me. Whenever I see anyone progressing, my heart is ready to get bullets. Have mercy upon me. Whenever I see anyone do anything that's doing more than me, I am like my eyes red. Father, have mercy upon me. I am a stingy woman. All I know is me, myself, my wife, and children. Father, have mercy upon me. Father, purge me. Purge me. You know your own. I know my own. You see what God said to the Philistines. Be strong, enemy of Israel, and destroy them. I know them, my people, but destroy them in my face. That is the God is saying. Cry to God this morning that our dry fast is going to not dry us into hell. We are coming to see the face of God tomorrow. Let us purge ourselves today now. We need the edge of protection. We need to protect our edge of protection. Cry to God. Cry right to God. Say, Father, have mercy. Jesus, have mercy. Sister, all moving to cry to God. Say, Father, have mercy. Wherever I've ever offended my husband, wherever I've ever offended my children, Father, I am sorry. Forgive me. Whatever I say concerning something, I am sorry. I am the one that broke someone's home. I am sorry. I still, when I was true, Father, I am sorry. Lord Jesus, forgive me. Don't keep anyone. It's between you and God. Don't keep anyone. There was a time I was so angry. I always praise my husband. You praise him already. Father, I have done this. Have mercy upon me. My husband offended me. I almost praise him. Father, I am sorry. My wife offended me. I almost pressed her neck when she was sleeping. Father, I am sorry. Forgive me. I was in another preached one lesson. I was so angry. I almost killed him through. I am sorry. I hate this man because of his message. Father, I am sorry. Forgive me. Forgive me. I was once a drug addict. Forgive me. I was once a drug pusher. Forgive me. I am a witch. I am a wizard. Forgive me. And deliver me. I am blessed by this spirit. I oppress people in the night. Father, I come to release it out with you. Forgive me. My heart is full of pride. I am a very proud person. Father, I come to release it with you. Forgive me. Forgive me, forgive me. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, you only use my mouth to preach this message. I am no better than those you need to preach to. Father, I am dirty. My mouth is dirty. Father, my heart is dirty. Have mercy upon me. Have mercy upon me. I have come to reason my life out with you. Father, deliver me from sin. Father, deliver me from sin so that you not give my enemy to fight me in the name of Jesus Christ. While I'm saying seven times Holy Ghost fire, the enemy will be destroyed. Have mercy upon me. Wherever I've broken my head of protection, have mercy and rebuild again. I want to pray. Have I broken my head of protection? Father, have mercy and rebuild in this hour. If my head of protection is broken, and I still wake up in 11 o'clock praying, and the enemy are laughing. Pray, I'm going to sleep, and let us continue our job. They will oppress you, wake up and pray. Hey, do the prayer and go back, and let the work continue. The head of protection is broken. Say, Father, please have mercy, and use my head of protection. Demons cannot come to the house that God is dwelling. Let us cry out to God. Our earthly protection are broken. That's why we see ourselves in this century. Say, Father, renew my edge of protection. Let us all from this mountain right now assume what you are not. We are all the same right now. We are all guilty. Let us all cry out to God. If you think you are holy, ask the Holy Ghost to search you to see how dirty you are. If you are listening to this thing, it's not me, it's talking to you, it's talking to Brother Ferdinand, it's talking to your sister. Hey, let the Holy Ghost be smart and set you. You see, you are all dead than Jacob. The Bible says our righteousness is like a filthy rat. Cry out for mercy. Cry out for mercy. Cry out for mercy. Father, have mercy for me. Have mercy for me. Have mercy on my wife. Have mercy on my children. God, just so God, we are sorry. We are sorry. We have used our own head to break our edge of protection. Father, we are the kids in Israel that went to my current empty ark of covenant. We shout empty shout. We call empty fire. Fire, 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 fire. What is happening? And God has said that on behalf of the people in heaven, we pray for mercy. Let us cry. We are seen. All the solution and redemption plans for life. We all have seen the great God. All the colors of love we have seen. We see a dead heart. We are seeking with dirty tongue. Our profitable the speech with dirty tongue. Have faith. Because I know our edge of protection has been renewed again, except your holy name. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we have prayed. And as we all have come to reason with our God this hour, Satan and his demons will never come to reason with us again in the night in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Whenever they are dreaming of all those kind of dreams, it means the devil is reasoning with us. But from now on, as Christ is telling, our link with the devil are hereby broken in the name of Jesus Christ. Are you out there? You are not born again. Please, I am begging you, you don't even have the edge of protection at all. Say after me, you want to give a life to Jesus Christ. Say, Lord Jesus, I have heard your word. I confess that I am a sinner worthy of damnation of hell. Have mercy upon me. I come to live with you this hour. Forgive me all my sins. I know my name is not in any way close to the book of life. But Lord Jesus, have mercy. Take my name away from the book of death and write it in the book of life. I accept you, Lord Jesus Christ, today as my precious Lord and Savior. Come into my life. Come and dwell in me. I am born again today. All things are passed away. Behold, all things have become new. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, for saving my soul. I go now to see no more. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
That's the inspiration. I pray, God Almighty, I have mercy upon you. I'll give you your faith and take you as his own. Give you the end of protection around you and give you and every one of us the grace to run this race to the end of time and see us in glory on the last day. In Jesus Christ, mighty name, we pray. Amen. Not against any of us, we all, through this message, we see God on that day in glory in Jesus Christ, mighty name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Over to you.
Be sure.
Shepherd of our soul.
Lord,
Shepherd of our soul.
Lord,
Shepherd of our soul.
We are.
And now we are the righteousness of Jesus. We are risen with him. Holiness and righteousness, and that tomorrow, joy is yours forever.